Washington, D.C. and the music scene here, I wouldn't be standing up here with the mic right now.
The experiences that I had here set this foundation for the rest of my...
I better turn that off. I don't want to do any copyright issues with YouTube. Hey everyone, I'm doing Sonic Highways Episode 2, the Washington, D.C. episode. You know, I did the first review for Sonic Highways of, was in Chicago. And I did a decent review, I think, but I think I left a lot on the table. And as I'm looking around for reference materials to jog my memory, there's not a whole lot out there. So I'd have to basically sit down and watch the show again, take notes. Sorry, I'm not taking explicit notes. Just to talk about who's in the episode, because one of the most interesting things to me are the musicians and the icons that they interview and that pop up sporadically throughout the show. And, well, let's just go ahead and get started with Sonic Highways, Episode 2, Washington, D.C. And the song that they're recording on this one is called The Feast and the Famine. You know, I don't really remember that song, so I may have to go listen to it or play that. I mean, I could do that. I could spend 3 or 4 minutes to listen to a song again to figure out if I remember, you know, like that or not. But the entire episode, the premiere episode in Chicago was pretty good. But the Washington episode, the episode 2, was not that great. They were talking about, let me give you the summary here off of Wikipedia. Washington, D.C. is in many ways a city of extremes. Starland Vocal Band. I guess we're supposed to say it like that. Starland Vocal Band. Marvin Gaye, Duke Ellington, Niles Lofgren. Or is it Nils? Nils Lofgren. There's no E. Chuck Brown, Henry Rollins, Fugazi, and Trouble Funk. They all hail from D.C. In the early 70s, the music style go-go originated here and has remained a local craze ever since. Dave Grohl sits down with Trouble Funk's Big Tony Fisher to talk about go-go and explores its origins with Chuck Brown, the genre's undisputed godfather. He also chats with Don Zientara, owner of Inner Ear Studio, which the Virginia-raised Grohl says produced the entire soundtrack of my youth. Produced the entire soundtrack of my youth. There you go. That's the exact quote. As well as with members of the punk band Bad Brains and Ian McKay of Teen Idols, Minor Threat, and Fugazi, all who recorded at Inner Ear over the decades were part of Washington, D.C. hardcore scene. Okay. The song Feast and Famine is recorded during this episode. So, you know, it's kind of funny is, where on there does it say Skeeter Thompson? Did it? Did I say Skeeter Thompson? No! But Skeeter Thompson is a bass player who sits in on Feast or Famine, and he's from the band, DC hardcore band Scream. And some dude named Peter Stahl. So they get to be in the song and in the video. But there's really nothing memorable about the episode, much like there's nothing memorable about this review of it. I'm sorry, but I'm giving you the real life feel for how the episode hit us. It's just, you know, again, I like Dave Grohl, I like Foo Fighters, but, you know, the go-go scene, all that was... whatever. I mean, it was semi-interesting, but just when you think that, I think the thing about this series that I'm not really liking is just when you think you're connecting with Dave Grohl's memory or his thoughts, feelings, emotions about the scene and the city that they're in, they sort of leave that and then they cut into this cool thing about the historical aspects of the music of the time. It's like, okay, I can get into this. It's kind of like you're watching 3 documentaries at the same time. You're watching, what does Dave Grohl think about this? Or other Foo Fighter members, like you'll find out in the coming episodes. And then you're like, oh, well, what are some of the other, you know, historical names or the iconic figures think about it? And like, oh, you talk about that for a little bit, briefly. And then you get to know the studio, which in this case is Inner Ear Studios. Okay, so, all right, the studio, cool. And all the while, they're you know, they're going through and they're force feeding this to you, to where at the end, like I said in the previous episode of this, the lyrics play across the screen of the music video of the song at the end when they debut it. And you see that, you know, Dave's like writing the whole song, you know, writing the lyrics, and the lyrics are basically, I mean, you know, there's something to be said about good musicians and good songwriting or whatever, and they're, you know, Dave Grohl is definitely that. But it's like, here, the lyrics to the song are literally, "Hey, I'm just telling you the things you just heard and watched on the show. And I'm talking about things specifically that you just watched." I mean, it's kind of stupid, to be honest with you. And you'll see what I'm talking about if you watch the show. But, so I'm mixed at this point. The Chicago episode, I was like, oh, this is exciting. This is a cool thing, you know, whatever. Sonic Highways, I can't wait to watch all of them. Buy the DVD, the collector set. But, you know, I'm not sure after the Washington, D.C. episode. It's all talking about how there's nobody's born in D.C. You know, it's like the city of politics and the city of, what's the word I'm looking for? Just transient type people. And that's the way this episode flowed. It was just sort of transient, like it didn't really have a place to be. So, you know, I guess I gave the first episode a pretty high score on a scale of, I guess, 3.75 out of 5 stars, if I remember correctly. But this episode, no matter who was in the episode, musicians, icons, otherwise, that I remember later after I post this, I do know that this one was not good at all, in my opinion, and I'm going to have to give it 1 star. So, 3.75 out of the gate, down to 1. Still like Foo Fighters, we're still watching it. I mean, I've seen Nashville, Austin, and Los Angeles. So I've got those 3 in my quiver to give you a review on. And we're still waiting for New Orleans, Seattle, and New York. So right now it's split. You got 1 episode that's pretty decent and 1 episode that I could have done, you know, it was boring. So, all right, well, just share your thoughts if you're watching the series. Share this with your friends. Leave comments. Like, please, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and Blabby Daddy out.